Hi everyone, welcome to Mash Math. Today we are going to study chapter 8, Introduction to Trigonometry, exercise 8.4, question 1. Express the trigonometric ratios sin A, sec A and tan A in terms of cot A. Meaning to say, all these expressions sin A, sec A and tan A, all these three we have to express it in terms of cot A. So there are two methods are there. I'll show you both the methods. Whichever one you find easy, please you follow. According to me, the first method, what I'm going to show you is very easy method. That is completing the triangle. Okay. So we know that right angle triangle okay. So we can take this as a A, B, C because here everywhere A is given. So we'll take A as a theta. So that means theta is here. So if this is your theta, opposite to the theta becomes what? Perpendicular. Opposite to theta is perpendicular and opposite to 90 degree becomes hypotenuse and the third side becomes base. So this we know. So now let us start from here only. Cot A. Okay, cot A and cot A is actually what? If you remember the ratio, that also please remember princess beating prince horribly, horribly beating. So this is actually what? Sin, cos, tan, cosec, sec and cot. So now cot means what? Cot is actually base upon perpendicular. Base upon perpendicular. Okay. So now we know that cot A means angle A. Angle A is here. Theta is here. So base is what? This side. BA and perpendicular is what? That is BC. Okay. So now what we will do here. This is in ratio, but here no ratio, so we consider that there is 1 is here. Okay, so now base is what actually? Cot A. So you can write down here, base is cot A. Okay, then perpendicular is what? 1. So this is perpendicular, so perpendicular is 1. So that means we don't know what is hypotenuse, so we have to find out hypotenuse. Okay, so you can write down. Base is BA, perpendicular is BC. Okay, so then the value we have put it here. So now use the Pythagoras theorem and find out the hypotenuse side. Using Pythagoras theorem. So what the Pythagoras theorem says, hypotenuse square is equal to base square plus perpendicular square. So hypotenuse is what? AC square. Base square is BA, you write, or AB is the same. Since I have written BA, I am writing BA. BA square plus perpendicular is BC square. So now AC square we don't know, so we keep it as it is. BA is what? Cot A. So cot A. Square it is, whole square we don't write, we write cot square. A. Okay. Then plus BC. BC is 1 square. So that means AC square is equal to cot square A plus 1. Now square you bring it this side. So square comes means it goes to root. So cot square A plus 1. So hypotenuse value we got, that is what hypotenuse value is, under root cot square A plus 1. Okay, so we know base now, we know perpendicular and we know the hypotenuse. Now just write the values that are asked of us. Sin A we have to write, sec we have to write and tan A we have to write. So first let's write for sin A. Sin A is what actually? Sin is what? Perpendicular upon hypotenuse. So perpendicular upon hypotenuse. Perpendicular is what? Perpendicular of value is 1. Hypotenuse is what? The root cot square a plus 1. This is for sine, because what we have to do actually in this question, sine a, sec a and tan a, we have to express them in terms of cot a. So that means now sine a we have turned into cot here. So now we'll do for sec a. Sec is what? Hypotenuse upon base. So hypotenuse is what actually? The root cot square a plus 1. And base is what? Base is cot a. Okay. So sec also became in terms of cot. So now we have to do for tan a. So tan a is what? Tan is what? Perpendicular upon base. So now perpendicular value here, perpendicular is here, that is 1. Base is what? Base is cot a. See, this is our answer. So isn't it easy? Because you have to just complete the triangle, then we just write the value. Now I'll show you another method. If this method, you need a lot of practice, because I have taught you identities. We have to use the identities here. I have explained to you trigonometric identities. So we have to remember all these identities. If you remember all these identities, then you can do it that method also here. Okay. So using the identity, let us write for sine a. So sine a can be expressed in identity, I have told you. Sine can be written. Sine is inverse of cosec. So sine can be written as 1 upon cosec. Okay. Then cos can be written 1 upon sec. Tan can be written 1 upon cot. So same with this. Cosec can be written 1 upon sine. Sec can be written 1 upon cos. Cot can be 1 upon tan. So all this identity you have to remember. Whatever I have explained to you, this identity, you have to learn this by heart. So using this identity also you can solve this sum. Okay. So now sine a can be written 1 upon cosec a. Theta is a, so that's why we are writing a. Now my identity, remember this identity, cosec. So when cosec becomes a square, then we can get the cot theta here, cot, okay. So what we will do, convert this into square. So you remember that x square, if we write square, you cancel means the root also will get cancelled. So that means what we will get? X. So that means x can be written under root x square. So same way, can we write this? This can be written under root cos x square a. Okay. So now we have made it into square now. So cosec square has become, theta is what? A here. So cosec square theta can be written as 1 plus cot square theta. So can write that 1 plus cot square theta is A. Okay. So this is what the answer is. You see here the first one we have written when we completing this value when we wrote. So what we got? Same answer we have got, 1 upon 1 plus cot square a. So you write either 1 plus cot square a or cot square a plus 1 is the same. Okay. So now same way, let's go for the second one, that is sec a. So sec, how can we write sec also again? Can we make it a square now? Because our identity we have here. See, 1 plus tan square theta is equal to sec square theta. So sec square becomes, means we will get a tan, and tan is actually what? Inverse of cot. I told you tan is what? Inverse of cot it is. So we will get into cot. Okay. So we can write this under root sec square a. So square comes means I told you can be written sec square sec square means 1 plus tan square theta. So 1 plus tan square theta, we can write this. So now 1 plus tan square theta can be written as 1 upon, because tan is what? Tan is 1 upon cot theta. So square is there, so we can write cot square theta. Okay, further you can solve this, because here denominator nothing is there, we consider that there is 1. So then what we'll do to get here also cot square theta, both side we have to multiply with cot square theta. So we will get cot square theta, here plus is there, plus 1, and here cot square theta. Okay, so now can we write separately? This can be written as 1 plus cot square theta, and this is under root, right? This is under root. So for this we can cancel the square, and so for this the root will go. So for then we will get cot theta. Okay, so this you see the same answer you got. Under root cot square a plus 1 upon cot a. So same way we have got it. So instead of theta we have to write a, because here a is given. Okay, here also that you have to remember. Okay, because angle is given as a, so instead of theta we will write a. So this is the second part. Now we'll do third part. Third is tan a. So tan we know, tan is what actually? 1 upon cot. So 1 upon cot A. So that's it. So to write this, actually this method to do, you should know the identity by heart. If you don't know the identity, then better you go for this method where you can complete the three sides of the triangle, and then you have to just write the, put the ratio and just write the value of that. That's it. I hope it is clear to you. Thank you and God bless you.